Welcome to St. Joseph Chapel and the Shrine of the Immaculate Heart of Mary. We are glad you are here to worship at this Holy Mass for the Feast of the Chair of St. Peter. Please be so kind as to silence or turn off all electrical devices to respect the dignity of Holy Mass. In the Blue Gather hymnals, inside the front cover, you may find the Angelus, which immediately precedes Mass, the Gloria, and the Creed. If you need the St. Michael prayer, which we pray after Mass, it is inside of the back cover. The handout is for the opening song and for the closing song. Extra seating is available if needed in the lower level where the Mass can be viewed and heard on a large screen TV. Thank you.
The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary,
and she conceived by the Holy
Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word became flesh. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God.
That we may be worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ thy Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our opening hymn is in the handout by All Your Saints Still Thriving. Again, that is the handout. We will be singing verses 1 and 2.
By all your saints still striving, for all your saints at rest, your holy name, O Jesus, forevermore be blessed. You rose our King victorious, that they might with a crown and ever shine in splendor, reflected from your throne.
Apostles, prophets, martyrs, and all the noble throng, who wear the spotless raiment and raise a ceaseless song, for them and those whose witness is only known to you, by walking in their footsteps, we give you praise anew.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, it is a privilege to be with you here at the Shrine this day, to be here to gather around the Feast of the Chair of Peter. When we with Peter confess our faith in the Lordship of Jesus Christ, And so as we prepare to celebrate these mysteries, we take a moment and ask God's pardon and peace for any rebellion, for any opposition that we have put up for Christ's plan to burst forth in our lives and in the lives of those we come in contact with. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
To God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest.
It's a bishop's prerogative, isn't it? Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that no tempest may disturb us, for you have set us fast on the rock of the Apostle Peter's confession of faith. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. James. Beloved, Where do the wars and where do the conflicts among you come from? Is it not from your passions that make war within your members? A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, I exhort the presbyters among you, as a fellow presbyter and witness to the sufferings of Christ, and one who has a share in the glory to be revealed. Tend the flock of God in your midst, overseeing not by constraint but willingly, as God would have it, not for shameful profit, but eagerly. Do not lord it over those assigned to you, but be examples to the flock. And when the chief shepherd is revealed, you will receive the unfading crown of glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. No resolving will lead me and refresh my soul. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. He guides me along the right path for the sake of his name. Though I should walk in the valley of death, no evil should I fear, for you are with me. Your crook and your staff will give me comfort. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. You have prepared a table before me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil, my cup is overflowing. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. It is the Lord's own house that I dwell for the length of my days. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. On this rock I will build my church. The gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus went into the region of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, "Who do people say the Son of Man is?" They replied, "Some say John the Baptist, others Elijah, still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter said in reply, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus said to him in reply, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my heavenly Father. And so I say to you, you are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it. I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. May the words of the Gospel cleanse us from our sin. I think I'm COVID distant enough here, huh? I'm so pleased to be at the Shrine of St. Joseph, I can't tell you. I'm embarrassed to tell you that it's my first time here, which should embarrass me, and it does, because I love St. Joseph so very much, and I love Our Lady. And one of the things St. Joseph always helps me to do is to love and serve Our Lady as I should. And so that's one of my favorite things about St. Joseph. But I have to ask you a serious question today. Are you ready for death? Are you prepared to die? It's not an idle question. Each of us will come to the end of our lives, and a day we don't expect. All of us will go and meet the Lord, and it should be, especially for those who are believers, it should be the greatest day of your life. Nothing greater except baptism. It's the day on which you will meet the Lord, on which Jesus will no longer be veiled from your eyes, and you will come into your Father's house. It should be something that doesn't cause you to be afraid. It should be something that causes you great joy. An anticipation that builds as you get older. Even arthritis and all the other itises that come along, they don't eclipse that joy that you're going to be with the one who is the object of your life. Amen?
Amen.
And so our death no longer has us captive. We're no longer held bound by death, right? Because of Jesus, because of our faith in him. And really, I shouldn't ask you, are you ready for your death? Because all of us must die to ourselves so that Christ might be alive in us. Amen?
Amen.
You see, that's the whole issue of discipleship. That's what Peter confessed. He confessed that Jesus is Lord. He confessed that Jesus is the Holy One of Israel, whom Israel ached for. And God, in his faithfulness, gave him to us. What's the plan here? The plan here is that God intends, according to St. Paul in his letter to the Ephesians, God intends to reestablish all creation in Christ. And that, first of all, means you. He wants to reestablish you in Christ. He wants to reestablish me. He wants Christ to be the foundation of my life. And when Christ is the foundation of my life and your life, then death no longer has any pull on us. Then death no longer is a tyrant to us. Indeed, death is a friend. You see, my brothers and sisters, what we're called to is not simply acknowledge that Jesus is Lord. We're called to press into that truth with our flesh and blood, with all that we are, with all our passions, with all our excellences, with all our weaknesses and brokenness, with everything. We're to give ourselves over to Christ, that he might reign in us, and that he might flow through us into the world. You know, we do a great thing when we come to Mass. We do a great thing in our part in procuring the salvation of the world. You don't just come to Mass for you. You come so that you, as Archbishop Vigdorin said, might be stamped with the self-giving love of Christ. That you might reproduce that love in your own lives. That that love might flow through you into the world. That you and me might become living tabernacles of the Lord Most High, of Jesus, of our Jesus. And that's what Peter said, didn't he? My Lord and my God, you are the object of my life, Jesus. And when I have you as the object of my life, then my life will become well ordered. Then the Lord can use me and flow through me into the world. And that's true for bishops, it's true for priests, that's true for all of us and each of us. Never forget that the highest calling in the church is not to be among the clergy. The highest calling in the church is not to be a pope. The highest calling in the church is to be a saint, is to be set apart for Jesus Christ, that he in his love might flow through us into the world, that he might touch our families, that he might touch our neighbors. You see, one of the things we have to remember is our salvation isn't just about us. It's about all those whose lives are tied to us and our own answer to the question of, who do you say that I am? My brothers and sisters, we're profoundly loved, and we must press into the truth that Jesus is Lord with all our hearts, that we, caught up in the mystery of Christ, might allow him to flow through us into the world. Amen?
Amen.
Having heard the Lord's, do we have the creed today? We do have the creed today. Sorry about that. Before we proceed to the altar, let us profess our faith publicly. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead,
and his kingdom will have no end.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess to one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Thank you.
With confidence in our Father's love, we turn to him through Christ our Lord.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, that the Holy Spirit will help him in his universal ministry of unity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the unity of the Church, that the Spirit of Jesus help our bishops grow the Church in truth and love, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Our Lady of the Cape, Queen of the Holy Rosary, and patroness of this shrine, may help this holy place and those who come here contribute to the unleashing of the gospel and the unleashing of grace in this archdiocese. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those preparing to follow Jesus Christ in the Catholic way of life, that with an ever-deepening docility, they be able to embrace and live Jesus' gospel teachings. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase of vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, that young men and women may generously respond to the invitation of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the many people suffering from sickness, isolation and loneliness, that compassionate Christians and the mercy of God may heal and console them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the salvation of all the dying, that Saint Joseph be at their side to help them know the boundless mercy of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious Father, we are your sons and daughters and have been made so by the blood of the Lamb. We ask you to hear these prayers, Father, and especially grant an increase in the gifts of supernatural gifts of faith, hope, and love. And we ask this, Father, in Jesus' holy name.
Amen.
Our offertory hymn can be found at number 677, A Living Faith 677, we will be singing verses 1 and 4.
Faith born of God, O live.
true to you till death.
Put the rest up.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the cause of his holy church.
Accept with favor, O Lord, we pray, the prayers and offerings of your church, that with St. Peter as her shepherd, she may come to an eternal inheritance. For it is through his teaching that she holds the faith in its integrity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you, the Eternal Shepherd, do not desert your flock, but through the blessed apostles, watch over it and protect it always, so that it may be governed by those you have appointed shepherds, to lead it in the name of your Son. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord. And all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint John the Baptist, our co-patron, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Alan, our Bishop, his assistant bishops, the order bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other some sign of peace.
That's for me.
That's for you. Okay.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should
enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be immortal.
Please join as you are able in our communion song, which can be found at number 742, The Church's One Foundation, 742.
The church is one foundation, is Jesus Christ her Lord. She is his new creation by water and the word. From heaven he came and sought her to be his holy bride. With his own blood he bought her, and for her life he died. Elect from every nation, yet one on all the earth, her charter of salvation, one Lord, one faith, one birth. One holy name she blesses, partakes one holy food, and to one hope she presses with every grace endued. Through toil and tribulation and tumult of her war, she waits the consummation of peace forevermore, till with the vision glorious her longing eyes are blessed,
and the great church victorious shall be the church at rest. Yet she on earth has union with God the three in one, and mystic sweet communion with those whose rest is won. O blessed heavenly chorus, Lord, save us by your grace, that we, like saints before us, may see you face to face.
Our second communion hymn can be found in number 932, One Bread, One Body, 932.
O God, who at our celebration of the feast day of the blessed Apostle Peter have nourished us by communion in the body and blood of Christ, grant, we pray, that this redeeming exchange may be for us a sacrament of unity and peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen. A few closing announcements before our blessing. We thank His Excellency Bishop Battersby for coming to visit us for the first time.
Thank you.
We're happy to have you here, and the rosary will follow the Mass. after the final blessing. And we will also pray the St. Michael prayer. So thank you all for coming.
Before I give the final blessing, it was a treat to be with you. I also didn't realize I have some friends here, the Jerzebowskis and Beth Hool, and so nice to see good and faithful people. So keep your bishops in your prayers, especially the Bishop of Rome. You just have no idea all the forces coming against that man. And some people think they're fit to judge him. And the only thing we're fit to do is to pray for him. So listen, this is Christ Church. And if he needs to deal with any of his bishops or priests, he will, believe me. But please pray for the Pope. Please pray for the chair of Peter. It is the sign and unifying strength of our church. And please pray for your local bishop, for Archbishop Vigneron. It's really true. Heavy is the head that bears the crown. And some people say, well, why didn't he do this? And I think, because you don't know about that. And sometimes you make decisions and people say, well, that's crazy. I was listening to Paul W. Smith this morning. He was talking about how silly the church's problem with the baptism of some of the some of their people, the deacon who used the improper words. And he was saying, you know, Jesus isn't going to care about that. You know, words don't matter. Oh, they don't, do they? Really? Think of this. When you said, will you marry me to your spouse? And they said, I do. That mattered to you, didn't it? And if they said no, it would have mattered to you a lot. Words matter. And we don't always understand why things don't go the way they should. But one of the things we have to do, and this feast day reminds us, is we have to remember Jesus is Lord. And we have to press into that truth and submit to that truth, even when sometimes we think things are going screwy. Because you know what? I don't always know what he's got in store. So anyway, it was a privilege to be with you. And I thank God for you and your faith. And I thank God with you for this beautiful shrine and your lovely pastor. Thank you, Father Alex.
My pleasure.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessings. May Almighty God bless you, for he has made you steadfast in St. Peter's saving confession, and through it has set you on the solid rock of the church's faith. Amen.
Amen.
And having instructed you by the tireless preaching of St. Paul, may God teach you constantly by his example to win brothers and sisters for Christ.
Amen.
So that by the keys of St. Peter and the words of St. Paul, and by the support of their intercession, God may bring us happily to that homeland that Peter attained on the cross, and Paul by the blade of a sword.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen. Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God. Saint Michael, the Archangel,
defend us in battle.
Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Our closing hymn, By All Your Saints Still Thriving, on the sheet, we will be singing verses 3 and 4. Again, that is By All Your Saints Still Thriving on the handout.
Then let us praise the Father and worship God the Son, and sing to God the Spirit,
eternal, three in one.
Terra the ransom number, who stand before the throne. Ascribe all power and glory and praise to God alone. We praise you, Lord, for Peter, so eager and so bold. Thrice falling yet repentant, thrice charged to feed your fold. Lord, make your pastors faithful to guard your flock from harm, and hold them when they waver with your almighty arm.
Thank you for being here. I'm glad. Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you. God bless you. Yeah, of course. Thank you for being here.
For those of you interested in our icon of Saints Peter and Paul on the lectern, I got that in Bethlehem, and His Excellency just blessed it for us. Mm-hmm. It's got Peter and Paul. It's a Russian Orthodox icon of Peter and Paul on the. You can venerate it if you're interested.
Amount of beats or syllables.
thank you. Appreciate that. Thank you. Yeah, thank you.
I can suggest that instead of having it be the construction.
Because you want to make a donation.
Thanks, Joe.
Yeah, thank you, Father Alex. Very beautiful Mass.
Appreciate your coming.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, very beautiful. So I found this little T-Rex under the music desk today.
Oh, or, did
not
you?
T-Rex, a little Triceratops. So.
Okay, that's so fun. You found
it. I guess
that's hilarious.
He was my companion today during Mass. So
when you were lonely.
Exactly. So, but I mean that would be, I think, in my mind. So I would make that.
That's Cynthia. Oh, Cynthia. Okay. Cynthia, this is Laura. She was one of our early helpers.
It's not a bad idea.
Well, because if they said, no, don't get the gift, then why would you buy it?
No, they weren't the price. Well, no, I would still give them the whole gift. I won't give it a haircut.
Right. But, like,
but it would cover the whole thing.
But what I'm saying is that your gift would cover it, and you would still have some left over.
Thanks.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
And you play and you sing absolutely beautifully. Yeah.
No, thank you.
Thank you so much for being here. You added so much to your celebration.
I'm very glad. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
That's not a bad idea. You know, you say it to me. Would you want, if I did it, do you want a third manual at home, or you like the...
You don't need more than two manuals. Three manuals is, I mean, three manuals is awesome.
We will pray the rosary in just a few moments.
Whatever you want to do.
Well, the problem is, though, it's electronic, and I don't know that, like, you know, when the Russian guy comes and plays, I don't want people to, like, that your organ, I guess, because it's software, it can be messed up.
Father Alex tells me that I'm really the only one that plays here now.
No, there's a guy that does for Saturday.
Oh, like, really?
Russian guy.
Mm.
Anyway, that's not a bad idea.
Yeah.
That's not a bad idea.
I just got a two manual thing. So,
and just
he's not going to beat it up.
Go to Steinway again, right? Do you want me to... Do you want a different one at our house?
Same specifications.
Do you want a different one at our house?
The one that we have is great.
You don't want three manuals for that?
Three manuals is good for practicing, but it's extra money. We don't need it. I play mostly on two manual instruments now anyways.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Yeah, that's true.
It might be
because
overkill.
If I get overkill and replace ours with a three manual, I'm technically taking money away from the shrine, and that
right.
is if I reimburse myself for that.
Right. Yeah, I would just.
But you like the organ at home.
I do. Yeah. I'm actually about to start practicing again because I have a new piece that I want to learn.
Sorry about this, Joe.
It's fine. It's fine.
You take a lot of pride in, you know, sounding good and wanting to do right, and you're back here struggling with it. I feel bad.
I mean, you don't have to feel bad. It's no one's fault. I don't believe Father Alex. Like, it's not like he doesn't know. And so, like, that's like the hardest thing that you have to do is, like, you're playing off of one sheet and then you have to look at the other sheet backwards.
It would
and
be
then,
the type of thing
then, like,
that
the thing got changed.
He should agree on, like, a hymn with music and lyrics. And that way you can just, I mean, that goes.
This, like, I don't like doing this.
Would you be okay if I mentioned that to him? Because I don't. I know you won't say anything, but it's like, especially, can you imagine if he did it to David?
What would you say?
Can you imagine if he did it to David?
He has done this. And David has to practice for literally more than a week.
I would say for a musician, it would be much better if they didn't just have the hymn and the tune, but the key, the music and the words, so they have something to practice, because Joe has to switch back and forth from the music to the thing, and then if it's in a different key, while he's switching back and forth, he also has to transpose it to another key.
Yeah.
Is that what happened?
Well, no. What happened was, I looked back and forth from the piece of paper, like, there's no music on it. So I look back and forth, and then I'll lose my place.
Okay.
Because it's not, I'm not following a consecutive line.
No, I see.
And then...
I don't even know how you could do that at all.
I mean, well, I just, eventually what I did was I would memorize a portion of that.
Well, could you have just gotten the tune of that and not worried about singing?
What do you mean?
Like, he says, I want this. To what tune? Then you get the tune in the gathered book and don't even sing.
I mean, that's possible, too.
That's what I would have done, because
did you hear me going quiet? When I started going quiet, that's just because I was trying to get my memories. Don't mention anything. It's fine.
No, even if you're ever getting pissed most important thing is you're playing the music, right? Mm-hmm. These people can carry the tune.
Yep.
So I would just be like, all right, I'm not worrying about that. I'm worrying about that. And then that's how you can do product or quality control.
Right.
That's all you can do. Otherwise, you spend so much time trying to do everything that you end up unintentionally creating a distraction if you right. really get lost.
Right.
So I just ditch that.
Yeah, I would too.
Or ask somebody to stand behind and maybe sing behind the microphone to fill that in as a pseudo lector.
No, it's fine. Like, I'll just balance it better. And like also like the tune getting changed on me today was also
I know.
That's just the double whammy. But like, so again, don't mention anything. So,
but if he said, gosh, you know, there were a lot of mistakes. Like, I want him to know why and not just, I'm not going to
do that. If he mentioned something about the opening, like the overdrive, I don't think it was that noticeable. Like, I covered it for fairly well.
It got better as it went on, but the beginning was rough.
Yeah. Well, also, this keyboard on the pedals has shifted, and so it's not used to what I say now. It's like, it's not what I say now. It's just a combination of factors, but I'm not trying to make excuses.
Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, right hand. The fruit of this mystery is moral courage. Our leader is Jen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy.
The fourth sorrowful mystery, our Lord carries the cross. In carrying the cross himself, he went out to what is called the place of the skull, in Hebrew, Golgotha. The fruit of this mystery is patience. Our leader is Maureen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace.
spirit. And when he had said this, he breathed his last. The fruit of this mystery is perseverance. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace. our Holy Father.